Welcome to the third lecture of our second module, which is on Bitvector Data Flow Frameworks. In the first lecture of this module, we have looked at the basics of Bitvector Data Flow Frameworks by trying to understand the problem of live variables analysis. In the second lecture, we looked at a different kind of a problem called available expressions analysis. Both these lectures have set up the basic concepts of Bitvector frameworks reasonably well. So this third lecture just explains reaching definitions analysis and is going to be a relatively shorter lecture. So what do we mean by a reaching definition? First of all, what we mean by a definition, an assignment X is equal to E, where E is some expression, is called a definition. It's a definition of a variable X and it's given an identity, a label. Here we are showing it by dx. So that assignment is set to reach to a given program point. So we are talking about this assignment dx. So this particular assignment, which refers to, so this dx is the label and assignment is x is equal to e. It reaches a program point P if it appears without a redefinition of X on some path from program entry to P. What this means is that a definition is an assignment to a variable, and when it reaches a program point, there is a possibility that that program point could use that variable and we may be able to perform copy propagation, which is the main application of reaching definitions analysis. There are basically two applications. One is the construction of defuse and useDef chains, which are essentially some edges imposed over a control flow graph, and these edges connect definitions of variables to their users or vice versa. And a copy propagation optimization is something that we have already seen in the very first introductory lecture. The essential idea is that the use of a variable X at a program point P can be replaced by Y if dx, the definition dx, which should be X equal to Y, which is X equal to Y, is the only definition with which reaches P and Y is not modified between the point of this definition dx and P. We will see more examples of copy propagation as we go along. But let's try to formulate a data flow analysis for reaching definitions analysis. But before that, let's look at examples of defuse and useDef chains. So here is a simple example. It has some definitions of variables A, B, C, M, and there are uses of these variables. So these are the defuse chains of the definition A1. The definition A1 reaches all these program points. The definition A1 reaches this use of A, it reaches this use of A, it reaches this use of A, it reaches this use of A, and it reaches this use of A. The idea is there is some path along which the value of A equal to 4 reaches these particular assignments, these particular uses of the variable. And then we ask a question, can we replace this use of a variable by the right hand side of the assignment to A? Similarly, the other definition of A, which is A2 here, which is this definition in this block, which is A is equal to A plus 1. This definition reaches this use. This definition also reaches a use within the same assignment statement because of this particular package. This assignment is increment is happening within a loop. So what is defined is getting used here. Similarly, this definition is used, this value of A could be used in this particular expression and could be used in this particular expression. Similarly, we could have useDef chains where per use we connect to the definitions that might be reaching here. So in this case here, this use of A has this use, so we have a useDef chain from this use of A to this definition of A and this definition of A, because these are the two definitions that reach here. Similarly, we have the use of A in statement 6. We have used F chains. These are the definitions that are, these are the possible definitions of A that reach here. So we can create a used F chains here. It's easy to see that these chains can be constructed once we have a set of definitions reaching a program point. So the important observation here is that this is how reaching definitions analysis is different from all other analyses that we have seen so far. The important point is there's a need to distinguish between different occurrences of lexically identical definitions. So if I have x is equal to y in one block and if I have x is equal to y in some other block, these two y's may be different, their values may be different, and therefore we do not treat them as identical definitions. We treat them as different definitions just because they appear at different program points. This is unlike, let's say, available expressions analysis, where A star B anywhere is considered A star B. So what we do here is a definition is identified by the label of the statements, and therefore we have A1, A2, A3, and A1 and A2. In this case, of course, we don't have an example, but it's possible that we might have a definition D1, which defines a variable X and the right hand side is Y. We might have another definition D15, which defines a variable X and the right hand side may again be Y, but just because they appear at different program points, they are considered as different definitions. So we define, as usual, gen and kill sets. So gen, these sets essentially contain the sets of definitions. So gen says that it contains, we use a label DV, which is created uniquely for every such definition encountered. We say this definition is included in gen set provided the variable V is defined in basic block N, and if this definition is not followed within the basic block N by a definition of V. Similarly, we define the kill set, which is the set of definitions where we say basic block N contains a definition of V. The idea is if a basic block has a definition of V, the preceding definitions of V do not go across, do not flow across these basic blocks. With these gen and kill sets, now we construct our data flow equations. Observe that like available expressions analysis, these are forward data flow equations, in that at the entry of a node, if N is a start block, we have boundary information. Otherwise, at the entry of a node, we essentially take the values of the exit of the predecessors. But unlike available expressions analysis, here we use a union and not an intersection, because in available expressions analysis, we wanted the expression to be available along every path. In case of reaching definitions, if you recall our statement of what a reaching definition is, we said a definition reaches if it reaches along some path, and therefore our confluence operation here is the union operation. And the outset is computed much in the similar way. We include the definitions that are generated, and then we remove the definition that are killed from those that reach the entry, and the union of these two give us the data flow value at the exit of node N. There's something interesting about the boundary information. Boundary information says that at the entry, unlike live variables analysis where we said for expressions involving local variables, the boundary information is empty set. Here we assign a new value undef. We want to say that every variable is undefined in the beginning, and we accommodate that by assigning a special assignment, special definition x equal to undef for all variables in the var. And here in and out are sets of definitions. We want to understand the role of boundary information and why it is essential. Assume that in this example, we do not have the boundary information of the kind that we are talking about. Then we have x equal to 5, this definition reaches here. And because only one definition reaches here, and we know that the right hand side of this assignment is not modified, can we replace this x by 5? This would be okay if we know that this path is not going to be executed. If this path is executed, then it's possible that there is some other definition through parameter or some such thing, some other value which is reaching here. We would like to suppress this particular copy propagation, and this is possible only when we introduce the boundary definition x0. So when we introduce x0, then we have x0 and x1 both reaching here, and when we have two definitions reaching a program point, we do not consider it for copy propagation, and this ensures that our optimization is sound. So let's look at a tutorial problem for copy propagation. This is the same example that we had seen. Initially, we perform local copy propagation and constant folding, which is perform copies locally within a basic block, and wherever we find expressions involving constants alone, we perform the expression evaluation at compile time and replace it by the resulting value, and that gives us this program where this definition m, the right hand side of this assignment becomes 6 because the value of c is 3 and the other argument of this expression is 2, so 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. So we get this particular instance of local copy propagation and constant folding. There is no other instance of local copy propagation and constant folding. And now we go on to perform reaching definitions analysis for performing copy propagation on this particular program in which local copy propagation and constant folding has been done. We define gen and kill sets here. Observe here that in node 1, we have definitions A1, B1, C1, M1 being generated, and we have the definitions being killed are all definitions of A, all definitions of B, all definitions of C, and all definitions of M. So the assumption is that before we perform this analysis, we have performed a certain analysis. We have gone through all statement once to collect all definitions. This is similar to doing available expressions analysis, where we say we know all expressions that appear in the procedure. We already know what the universal set is. But curious thing here is this definition A0. Why is this used? So what we have done is we have introduced this notion, the notation V0, which denotes the definition of V equal to undef for the boundary information. Also, we have ignored temporary variable T1, which is used locally within the basic block, in particular in this basic block. So now we have A0, B0, C0 and M0, all these definitions are killed. Basic block 2 has no assignment, so no definitions generated and no definition is killed. Basic block 4 also is just a condition check, so no definition is generated, no definition is killed. Basic block C is again no value, there is no assignment, no value is changed, so no definition is generated, no definition is killed. Basic block 3 defines A2, and therefore all definitions of A are killed. Basic block 4 defines A3. Recall that we have decided to ignore the variable T1, temporary variable. So basic block 5 defines A3 and it kills all definitions of A here. So this is our gen and kill set for each node. And now we perform reaching definitions analysis. Because it's a union problem, our initialization is empty set. And therefore, at the end of the first iteration, we get these values. We have A0, B0, C0, M0 at the entry of 1, which is the boundary information. However, all these are eliminated by these assignments. So we have at the exit of one A1, B1, C1, M1 reaching. So we have A1, C1, B1, M1 reaching here. We have the same thing reaching the node 3 as well. In node 3, we have this assignment A2, which kills the previous assignment A1. And now we have A2, B1, C1, M1 reaching here. And we now go to this node. Note that we will have to incorporate the effect of this back edge, and that will happen in the second iteration. So here once again we have A1, B1, C1, M1 reaching. Here also we have A1, B1, C1, M1 reaching. However, at the exit we have A3, B1, C1, M1 reaching. At the entry of node 6, we have A1 reaching along this path, and we have A3 reaching along this path. So we have A1, A3, B1, C1, M1, and the same set reaches the exit of the block. And when we perform the next iteration, we observe that this definition A2, which is generated here, now reaches the entry of 2, and hence it reaches all program points. It doesn't reach the exit of 3 because it is killed. It is killed as well as generated within the basic block 2. So it was already there. So therefore this is not shown as red. It is not shown as red here because although A2 reaches here, it is killed by A3. Now if we were to perform any more iterations, we will find that the data flow values do not change. So this is the result, stabilized result of reaching definitions analysis. And now we see how we can use it for performing copy propagation. Let's examine the situations one by one. So now here in this particular, this is a use of M, and we have a definition M1 reaching, only one definition of M1 reaching, and its right hand side is 6, it's constant, so it cannot change. And therefore, what we can do is we can replace this M by its right hand side in the definition M1, which is the value 6. So now we get A less than 6. This is the outcome of copy propagation. Similarly, here in these blocks, we have B and C being used. A single definition of B reaches here and a single definition of C reaches here. Note that B, the right hand side of both these definitions are constants, they cannot change in between, and hence we can perform copy propagation with them, and we replace B by 2 and we replace C by 3, right? So that is the scope of copy propagation in this particular example. This is how our optimized program looks like. So what is the advantage of doing this? The advantage of doing this is we can now perform dead code elimination, because at the end of basic block 2 only A is live. If we were to do live variables analysis, we will discover that only A is live. We observe that in this particular program neither B, neither C, neither M is being used. We have anyway ignoring T1, and T1 is reassigned here. So the only variable that is live here is A, and therefore all these assignments can be eliminated as instances of dead code elimination. So this is the optimization, and we get this particular program. So that explains reaching definitions analysis, and we will stop here. In the next lecture, we will take a look at the fourth example of a bit vector framework, which is the anticipable expressions analysis, and we will conclude this module by looking at common properties of bit vector data flow frameworks.